I like how on every album there's like a punk song. There's
Yeah.
like one punk song on every album.
They do sneak some punk
I
in. I was
know.
surprised. I think that there was a song off of, like, I think it was I Lovin' You, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Hey guys, it's Monday morning. I have 11 eBay orders to ship out. But first, I want to tell you about a podcast that I recorded last night. Some friends of mine that you saw at the beginning of this video have two podcasts. One is called Good Band, Bad Band. The other is called Record Roundtable. And for Good Band, Bad Band, what they do is they take two bands whose names kind of match up. Like last time we did the Moody Blues Traveler. And they kind of do a deep dive into each one and then pick which one they think is a good band. Other one we did is called Record Roundtable, where they go into an artist's discography and just kind of talk about them for an hour. And we did the Avett Brothers, which is one of my favorite bands. So if you guys like music, I think you'll enjoy these podcasts. I'll put a link down in the description for both of them. All right, let's get to work. All right, first order has two items. They're both in A5. Let's see. First is NBA Jam for Genesis. And next is Twisted Metal for PS1. Same buyer bought them both for $36.98 for shipping. These games are going out. So if you're named Mike, Mike, thank you for the support. I really appreciate it. Sold something else in here. Let's see. It's a little lighter. I believe it is this one right here. This is an Omsko light. Got this at a garage sale for $1. Sold for $9.99 plus shipping. All right, that's it for A5. We'll put that back. Next is in D3. This is a garage door keypad. I got this for $1. It sold for $14.99 free shipping. Next is in B5. It is Grey's Anatomy. What is it? Season 2. New in the plastic. Sold for $7.99 free shipping.
Your name Tommy bought this for his friend Jake. Tommy, thank you for the support. Hope Jake likes this.
Next thing is in C3. It's an NES game. Super Team Games. Has the sleeve and the manual. Sold for $10.99 free shipping.
Your name Jake bought that too. A different Jake though. Jake says, love your channel as it has really helped me out starting my own part-time reselling business. Thank you for passing on your knowledge to the people just starting out. Jake, thank you for the kind words. I wish you nothing but the best of luck in reselling.
Next is a hat in D1. This is an MLB Angels hat. I have a dollar into this. It's sold for $14.99 plus shipping. Next is a Wii game back here in F1. Guitar Hero Smash Hits for the Wii. That's sold for $29.99 free shipping. Next is an E2. This is a little cheat code thing for PS1. This sold for $24.99 free shipping. Next is a lot of 9 NES games right up here. These really weren't worth listing individually, so I just did one big lot. Some of them had sleeves, some had the manuals. Total, they sold for $39.99 plus shipping. And last thing I'm shipping out today is this miniature washing machine, the Eco Egg. I got this at a garage sale 2 months ago. I paid $20. It sold for $149.99 plus shipping. Hey guys, it is Tuesday, November 10th. It is 60 degrees outside right now. It's going to get up to 80 today. It has been unseasonably warm lately, and I'd love it. So I'm going to open up this back door, and we're going to get the day started. This place is an absolute mess right now. I bought up a bunch of video games and accessories and everything. So yesterday I was trying to sort through a bunch of it and, you know, toss what was bad and keep what's good. I started organizing kind of by console. And then we come here and it is not much better. Just a big mess. I did like 2 or 3 different bulk buys last week. So I'm sitting on a lot of inventory and I didn't really know where to put it. So just kind of all in disarray right now. So I'm going to work on getting this cleaned up today and test some of these consoles and do some listing. All right, I can see most of the floor in here now, so that's progress at least. I kind of organized a lot of the games by type and just tried to make it everything a little bit more concise. I was in the middle of cleaning up in there, and I got an eBay message I want to share with you guys. This is for a book that I sold about a week ago. Let's see, the sale date was November 6th, and today is November 10th. So 4 days ago I sold it. It was a Friday, and I looked at the time, and it sold at like 11:30. And I went ahead and shipped it out that day so that they didn't have to wait, you know, till Monday or whatever. So this is the message I get. 5 days plus for this. From 288 miles, 4.5 hours away, exclamation point, question mark.
Not here until Thursday, November 12th. It takes a whole freaking week from a state away to get an item through your wretched, half-cocked media mail cop-out. Pathetic, all caps, simply pathetic. You are definitely flirting with neutral or negative feedback. Scary. This is inexcusable and unacceptable to me. So there's a lot to unpack there. First of all, that's the first message I even received from the guy. So I don't know what he means by cop out. He paid for it to ship it media mail. That's, you know, what I offered, and he paid for it, so I shipped it media mail. And I'm sure many of you guys know media mail just takes longer to get there. So I'm assuming he thought I would reply, and that would be my response, is that, like, yeah, it's media mail, it's gonna take a little while. Not to mention everything else going on with the post office right now, like pandemic, we're in Q4, so a lot of, you know, Christmas sales, all the elections. There's a lot of reasons that stuff is getting delayed, so he's just all kinds of mad, which is kind of funny to me. Then we'll get to the threat. So let's talk about the negative feedback threat. I've had this happen before, and you can call eBay, and honestly, I hate to say this, but it depends who you get on the phone. If you get somebody that's understanding, like, a lot of times they'll just remove it. Like, yeah, like, as a seller, there's nothing that I could have done differently. I have, like, next day shipping. I shipped it the same day, so I got it out super fast. And once it's out of my hands, it's literally out of my hands, you know, unless it gets lost or something. So once it gets delivered, if he leaves negative feedback, I'll call eBay. They should resolve it. If they don't, what I've done in the past is you get on Facebook, and there is an account called eBay for Business. It's on Facebook, and you can DM them and say, like, here's what happened. I already tried to call eBay, and usually they'll go over their head and fix it if you're in the right. You can't just get everything fixed that way. So I thought that message was really funny. I really don't let that stuff bother me or get to me, because that guy clearly has something wrong going on in his life that he's so worried about that book taking 5 or 6 days to get to him. So I just want to let you guys know how I'm going to handle it, and I'll keep you updated once it gets delivered, if he leaves negative feedback, and what I'll do to change it. All right, testing some consoles. I've got 3 PS2 Slims. Unfortunately, I only have 1 power cord, but I do have plenty of AV cords. So what I'm going to do is test all these, see what works, what doesn't work, and hopefully I've got at least one that works well, that I can, you know, bundle with power cord and this and some controllers and just sell it like that. I picked up this little higher TV. I saw Lonnie has one of these over at Shed Flips, and I really like it because it's so tiny. You can just do all your testing with it. You don't need this, you know, big, huge TV. Like, I've got my TV here, but it's hard to get behind it, and the cords aren't long enough to, you know, hook up over there. So pick this little guy up. All right, let's get this plugged in and do some testing. All right, this first one powered on. We got a signal. I'm gonna plug in the controller. Actually, I got a game in there, so I don't know why it's not showing the game. That's kind of weird. Yeah, the game's not spinning. Well, that's too bad. I'll test another one. Just out of curiosity, I'll put a different game in here to make sure that's the issue. It's making a noise like it wants to do something. Yeah, nothing's coming up. All right, so I'm gonna have to just sell this one as is. All right, I'm gonna turn this one off. We will hook up another one. All right, disc is in, it's making some noise, and I think it's gonna pull up. All right, this one might actually work. All right, this one's good to go. We got one more to test. All right, we got power. Let's see if we can get it to load this game. All right, 2 out of 3 works. That's pretty good, actually. First thing is up here in D7. It is a Conan O'Brien Funko Pop. This guy right here. Sold for $5.99. What's going on? So if you're named Patrick, he says, thanks for what you do on YouTube. Your videos are highly educational. YouTube is PKWPix. Instagram is also PKWPix. Patrick, thank you for the support. Really hope you like that Funko Pop. Next is an A4. It is this Miami Dolphins hat. I think I had it listed for like $15. Somebody sent an offer of $10 plus shipping, and I accepted. When they sent the offer, I can't remember if they said they were a viewer or not. So Mark bought this. Mark, if you are a viewer and you bought this, thank you for the business, man. It means a lot. Next is down here, B5. is a Wii game, Just Dance Disney Party. I have a dollar into this. It sold for $13.99 free shipping. Next is an A1, and I know I sold more than one thing out of here, so we're just going to bring the whole tote over. Let's see, I sold this right here, Rock Band Country Track Pack. This is with all the stuff that I got up in Piqua from Danny and Parker. This sold for $10.99 free shipping. Other game I sold out of there is Xbox game. Is it this one? No. There we go. Backbreaker. This is also with that stuff from Danny and Parker. This one sold for $12.99 free shipping. I listed all those bats yesterday I got from Danny and Parker, and I sold, I think, four of them already. One of them is still in here. It's in the office. Just kidding. It is in the car. So what I do with my bats is I actually put them in my storage unit. So I had a bunch of stuff I was going to take over there. And this is one of the bats right here. This is a Louisville Slugger Z2000. Let's see, this one sold for $59.99 plus shipping. And the others are in the storage unit, so we'll run over there and get them. All right, here are my bats. I store golf clubs in here too. Reason being is because they're awkward. They're not easy to store. And they just kind of get in the way in my warehouse, so I like to keep them in here. So I sold three of these. Let's see, first is a Mikan. I think it is this one. Yeah, this one. Mikan Ultra 750X. This sold for $49.99 plus shipping. Next is an Easton. This one right here. Raw Power, also a slow pitch softball bat. That sold for $49.99 plus shipping. And the next one is a big one. Right here, TPX Louisville Slugger Z1000. This is a very popular bat. I wouldn't say rare, but just popular. I didn't realize how much it was worth at the time. This sold for $269.99 plus shipping. You guys hear me say this all the time, but I cannot stress it enough. Don't walk by the sporting goods. If you're outsourcing thrift stores, garage sales, whatever, take a quick glance at the sporting goods. With baseball bats, the way to look it up and see if it's worth anything, the model number should be on the barrel. 9 times out of 10, you'll find a model number. It's usually small print, and it'll say, you know, model ZXB1000 or whatever. And you can look it up and see if it's worth anything, because some of them are worth a lot. Hey guys, it's Thursday morning. You might have noticed I skipped over Wednesday in this video because yesterday was Veterans Day, post office was closed, so I wasn't able to ship anything. But speaking of Veterans Day, I know that there are a lot of men and women that watch my channel who served in the armed forces. So really quick, just want to say thank you guys so much for your service. You are all heroes in my book. Today I've got like 22 or 23 orders going out. I got quite a bit of order. That's what happens when I don't ship for a day. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what we're starting with. These two things I went ahead and pulled from my storage unit. This is a Kung Fu VHS tape. I got this last year for a quarter, and it sold for $13.99 free shipping. Wayne and Allison bought that VHS. Guys, thank you for the support. Really appreciate it. Okay, this right here is a Wenzel backpack. I got this clearance down retail arbitrage last year for about $7, and the buyer bought this and a jacket. So the jacket is over here in C5. It is a Levi's denim jacket, and these two items sold for $42.98 plus shipping. Next thing I'm shipping out is a PlayStation 2 Slim right up here. It's got one controller, 10 games. This is part of the stuff that I got from Danny and Parker up in Piqua. This sold for $59.99 plus shipping. Next is down here in C6. It is this box right here, Brilliance New York Thermal Heating Mask. I've got $2 into this. It sold for $17.99 plus shipping. Next thing is back here in F1. This is Harry Potter DS game, also something I got from Danny and Parker. This sold for $13.99 free shipping. All right, next we're going over here to A3. Sold this knife set with a cutting board, and this is the last one I had. I had like 5 or 6 of these to start with. Only had a couple dollars into each one. This sold for $8.99 plus shipping. Viewer named Adrian bought this. Adrian, thank you for the business. It means a lot. All right, next thing is in C9. It is one of these Dorbs. Let's see, not the Daredevil. I think it's this one right here. Yeah, Magneto. That sold for $5.99 plus shipping. Okay, next is a model car that I listed yesterday. And let's see, it is a Mustang Boss 302, an orange one. And I didn't label where I put it, but I think it is right in here. Nope, not in there. Okay. Let's keep on looking. Oh, wait, here we go. Right in front of my face. That's why I didn't label it, because I didn't put it in a tote or a box or anything. Okay, so I got this a few days ago, part of a bulk buy. I spent like $140 for everything, so I've got about $5 or $10 under this car. It sold for $34.99 plus shipping.
Viewer named Rocco bought this car. Rocco, thank you for the support. I really hope you like the car.
Okay, next order has two items. First is an A2, and I better grab my phone here, because there's multiple of these in here. Okay, it's Charlene Ginny Cabbage Patch. Maybe there's not multiple. Maybe there's just that one. Okay, so that's the first thing. Next thing is an F5, so let's put this here. Let's come down here to F5. It is this Pirates of the Caribbean Dorbs. These two are going to the same buyer. They sold for $29.98 plus shipping. Next order is two hats, both in B1. It is an Ohio State Buckeyes hat and a Cincinnati Reds hat. I got this one from the Mojo Casher Crew that sold for $14.99 plus shipping. And I got this one from a garage sale that I paid about $2 for. This one sold for $9.99 plus shipping.
Both of these are going out to a viewer named Jimmy, who has bought from me before. So Jimmy, thank you for your continued support. It really means a lot.
Next is in C1. It is a vintage Detroit Red Wings Octo-wave shirt that was made for the playoffs from 1987. I got this from the Mojo Casher Crew, so I might have $3 or $4 into it. It says large, 42 to 44, but I mean, I don't know if you guys can tell scale-wise, it's really not all that big. So I made sure that I put the pit-to-pit dimensions and, you know, neck down and all that stuff, and I kind of put like, it probably fits like an adult small, I mean, if I'm being realistic. So hopefully the buyer saw that. It sold for $29.99, free shipping.
And if you're named Brandon about this, Brandon, thank you for the business. Hope you like the shirt.
All right, next thing I'm shipping out is down at A5. Is this NES Power Pad with a game. Got about $5 into this. That sold for $19.99 plus shipping.
Let's go into a viewer named Jared. He says, I've been watching you for about a year and a half now, and I've been waiting for the perfect item to buy to show my thanks, and this is it. I have the box, so I'll complete it and add it to my collection. Thank you so very much for your guidance, Jared. Jared, thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it.
Next is in C1. I think I sold more than one thing out of here, so let's just pull the whole bin. All right, first thing that I sold is a little Guitar Hero wireless dongle. Let's see here, some watches in here. There it is. This is part of the stuff I got from Parker and Danny, which is at the bottom of one of the boxes. This sold for $38.99 free shipping. Next is a patch right here, 58th Tactical Fighter Squadron. That sold for $9.99 free shipping.
Viewer named Ryan bought that patch. He said, hey John, I wanted to tell you I'm a huge fan of your channel and you are a big reason why I started reselling. In my first few months, I've made over $5,000 just going to yard sales and thrift stores. That is amazing, Ryan. I would love a shout out for my eBay store and Instagram, Flip Flop Resellers, and also some stickers would be awesome. Thanks from San Diego. Ryan, thank you so much for the business. I'll be happy to throw in some stickers for you.
Okay, I sold a watch out of here. Where is it? Here it is. Little Seiko. It's kind of cool because it is analog and digital, but didn't have a battery to test it, so just had to sell it like it is for $24.99 free shipping. All right, that's it for C1. Put everything back in here and close it up. Next order I'm shipping has two items. First is in C2. This is a 1970 Ford Boss Mustang. And next is in C8. It is right up here, Tony Stewart car. Same buyer got both of these for $24.98 plus shipping.
Those are going out to a viewer named Randy. Randy, thank you so much for the business. That really means a lot.
Our next thing is a Pontiac GTO. I want to say it's this one right here. Yeah. Box was a little damaged, unfortunately, but still sold. I've got about $5 into this. It sold for $19.99 plus shipping. Next is a game in A1. I think I sold two out of here, so I'll just go ahead and pull them both. First is the Matrix Path of Neo, complete with the case, sold for $14.99 free shipping. And next is Lord of the Rings Battle for Middle Earth for Xbox 360, that sold for $12.99 free shipping. Next is in C2. This is a Nintendo Game Boy Advance DS with a few games that sold for $99.99 plus shipping. Next thing is a wood storage cabinet. Let's see. Right back here. Not this small one, but this big one right here on the bottom. This is part of that bulk estate buy I made about a week ago. This is teak wood. Let's see, the brand is Kalmar. It's kind of a cool thing. I'm kind of surprised how fast it sold, because I thought it might take a while being such a specific thing. But this sold for $24.99 plus shipping. Okay, next is a dictionary. One of those dictionaries that I just recently bought. Question is, where did I put it? There it is. Okay, yeah, this thing's heavy. Got this at a garage sale last weekend for $3. It sold for $49.99 plus shipping. Next thing's a B5. This actually just sold about 10 minutes ago. So we'll just go ahead and ship it out. Let's see. This is a book, What's Wrong with the Movies. I went ahead and put it in a little poly thing because I didn't want it to get damaged in the bin. I got this about 3 weeks ago for $3. It sold for $14.99 plus shipping. It's Friday morning. I've got 5 eBay orders to ship out. First thing is right here in E1. It is Mario Kart for Wii. It is the disc only. Sold for $19.99, free shipping. Next is back here in F1. It's a Cabbage Patch pinup doll. This sold for $19.99 plus shipping. Next is over here in C3. This is a vintage Sony cassette recorder. It has the power cord and a little microphone, which is pretty rare. I have about $5 into this. It sold for $34.99 plus shipping. Next is in C2. This is Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3 and 4 for PS2. I've got $2 into these. They were not worth listing individually, so I listed them together. They sold for $13.99 free shipping. Last thing I'm pulling is in D3. This is a little Sony handheld recorder. I got this up in Cleveland at a little flea market. I got $4 into it. It sold for $17.99 free shipping. That recorder is going out to a viewer named Samantha. She says, "Hey John, huge fan of the channel. Been sourcing your eBay store for a while looking for something useful, and this is perfect. My job requires a lot of note-taking on the go, and this will help make things easier. I'm also a reseller. eBay store is TC Bazaar, and look up to you not only as a reseller, but as a human as well. You and Whitney are amazing people and have huge hearts. Thanks for being foster parents and all around great people. I appreciate your knowledge immensely." Samantha, thank you so much for the kind words. I can't tell you how much that means to me. I want to give you guys an update on that buyer that sent me that crazy message. He sent me another message the following day, like even longer. I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's like a novel. Just like all pissed off, like how it hasn't came yet. I'm going to get negative feedback and just all this crap. If you want to read the whole thing, I put it on my Instagram, and there's a link to my Instagram down below in the description. But I ignored that too, and I guess it got delivered the same day he sent that message, and he left positive feedback. He said like smooth transaction or something. I don't know. So after all of that, you know, complaining and whining, he still left me positive feedback. So I just want to let you guys know how that was resolved. All right, it has been a while since I've opened up mail. I've got 3 or 4 packages, a couple of envelopes. This first one is something that I purchased. It's been a couple of weeks, actually. I haven't torn these open yet. These are from the Thrift Mine channel. I'm sure a lot of you guys watching this know about Thrift Mine. So you got 2 of them in here. Let me pull the other one out. A couple stickers from Ryan and Pam. How cool are those? Sent a little note with it. "Dear John, thank you so much for the support and being a great friend. Hope you like the stickers. Keep dreaming." That was from Ryan, and Pam says, "Hi, Jonathan." I'm Pam, Ryan's sidekick. I know you thought I was going to say side piece. Okay, food is ready. Bye, Jonathan. Whitney, hi. Guys, thank you for the stickers. If you guys haven't checked out their channel, I highly recommend it. It's one of my favorites. I'll put a link down below in the description. All right, next is from Elmer. Oh, wow. Little Cincinnati Reds button. It's a really old one, actually. This is probably from the 50s or 60s, if I had to guess. Look at that. That is so cool. Thank you, Elmer. Okay, next is from Christian. "John, I've been a viewer of yours for a while now. You have helped me a ton with my reselling. I have bought something from you before as a thank you, but your videos continue to help me grow. I recently made a huge bulk buy vintage 90s leather ball team hats. I believe I've seen you wear a Bearcat shirt before, so I wanted to send you a hat as a thank you again when I seen this hat in the bundle. If any of your viewers would like to check them out, they are on my eBay, WalnutLog38. I love your videos and thank you for the help." Check out this hat. I actually went to UC. football team is doing really good this year too. Yeah, this is awesome. New old stock with the tag and everything. Thank you, Christian. All right, this one I had already opened. I didn't realize it was viewer mail, so I wanted to wait to like actually pull it out until I was recording. This is from the Scavenger Hut. It's a cool little sticker there. This is Jesse sent this from the Cincinnati Reds Hall of Fame Museum. This is slick. It's got a little spinny baseball on the handle. That is awesome. Thank you, Jesse. Okay, next just says it's from Watkins. We got a letter here. Cincy Picker, I've been enjoying your videos for a couple years now. I'm a part-time eBayer and you have helped me greatly. I was sourcing and found these. I hope they help ease the pain of losing to my Braves. Thanks for what you do and God bless, Nick. eBay Little Nicky 02. Yeah, that was a really rough series. I don't think I'm over that just yet. Oh, these are so cool. Red Sox. Grateful Dead Red Sox at that. Look at these. The Grateful Dead Reds logo. That is cool. Thank you, Nick. Okay, next is from, let's see, it's international. I don't know if there's a name on the box. It's from the UK. Dom. Dom sent this. It is packed really well. All right, we got a note here. Hi, John. Here are some things for you to say a big thank you for your YouTube videos. I hope Darcy will like the candy. I tried to get some that was not available in the US. I have a question for you. Have you ever lost an item you had sold? I had something listed and couldn't find it when it sold. I had to refund items and it was very embarrassing. I recently lost my job. I hate to hear that. I'm sorry. Because of COVID and I am turning to selling on eBay again. Thanks for the great videos. Regards, Dom. P.S. If you ever need anything from the UK or Europe, let me know. Thank you, Dom. To answer your question, yes, I have lost things. When I first started selling, I didn't have, you know, bins and a whole inventory system and I lost stuff all the time. I hated it. So that's how I adopted this. I didn't come up with this bin system. I saw it on a channel years and years ago, and just it works for me. So with every listing, I put where I located it, and now I can find it. Every once in a while, I'll forget to put the location when I list it, but then I just go back for the items that I listed that same day, and then I can usually find it in that bin. So knock on wood, I have not lost anything in a number of years. Cincinnati Reds pennant. Did you find this in the UK, Dom? That is cool. All right, there's some candy here. Got Nestle Smarties. Kind of looks like M&M's maybe. That's cool. Little Cincinnati Reds Matchbox car from 1990, no less, when they won the World Series. There's some more Smarties. And then we've got Love Hearts by Swizzles. That is pretty cool. Dom, thank you so much. This is really kind of you.
That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.